the master of meditation, the supreme serene, the four-time heavy thoughts champion of the world!
The setup for the movie is that the Scrat is going to find a UFO embedded in the ice. And actually, this reaches back to the first film where we had a funny gag where the, you know, Manny, Sid, and Diego were walking through essentially an ice museum. And they pass this this UFO in the ice, and we always thought, oh, that's really funny. We should do something with that. So Scrat is going to find this thing. He's going to activate it by accident, and it'll be blasting off into the cosmos. And so while he's out there, he's going to bounce around off the planets and eventually send an enormous asteroid heading towards Earth on a collision course. And our main herd will come up with a crazy plan to try and stop it.
What are you doing, Buck?
All rocks tell a tale. Where we've been and where we're heading. That, however, is a turd.
I think with any great movie story, no matter what setting it is if it's the Ice Age from thousands of years ago or sometime in the future, you have to have real characters with real relatable dynamics and family issues. And I think that's been the real strength of the Ice Age franchise, is we've come from a great core, and every character we've added has been a very particular and special flavor that really makes these characters live and breathe.
Greetings, mammals. The Shangri-Lama will see you now.
This is the guy who's gonna save us.
New topic, we're all about to die.
Well, that's no good. Stress is a killer.
Let us loosen our limbs and open our minds. Downward dog!
Seriously?
There's a lot of physical comedy that speaks across all languages, like that's common to everybody. And I also think that the issues that they've dealt with in terms of like the family growing and changing and evolving is also sort of a common human experience. We all know somebody like Sid or somebody like Manny somewhere in our family that that speaks to us. So even though mammoths, you know, are from thousands of years ago, they've got something that relates to us.
Figaro, 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 Figaro!
With you in a minute! I'll have to rinse and repeat.
Ugh, that weasel is such a buzzkill.
I came to Blue Sky in 1998, right out of college, and I interviewed at a bunch of different studios. I knew I wanted to be an animator, but there was something special about Blue Sky. I really felt that when I got here, there was an interesting family vibe, and I just loved the people, and I feel like we've been able to grow the team and, you know, retain essentially that spirit. So I've never wanted to leave. It's always been a great place.